हाँ जी, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल गाइस। मैं पहली आपकी केस पे मीटिंग ले रही हूँ एंड आई मस्ट से आई डिड प्रिफर द प्रीवियस मेथड मोर। अच्छा, इसको इस पे चले जी, स्लाइड्स पे शो पे। ओके, सो टुडे वी गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस टॉपिक ऑफ इनबॉर्न एरर ऑफ मेटाबॉलिज्म। And the topic today will just give you an overview. I mean, देखो metabolic errors तो बेशुमार हैं, जितने body में metabolic processes हो रहे हैं उतने ही metabolic errors भी मुमकिन है। So what we try to do is before I go on to specific inborn errors of metabolism, जो आपके course में, you know, this is a complex subject, जो आपके course में थोड़े से शामिल है, we just talk about the metabolic errors in general. So this is just an overview. Okay, now as I said, individually they are rare. Agar aap, let's say urea cycle defect le lein ya maple syrup urine disease le lein, so the incidence is rare. Lekin agar collectively aap log, if you make one big lump of all the metabolic errors that can take place, then they are pretty common. Also remember, although we're discussing pediatrics and they are considered to be the domain of the pediatrician, but they can actually present at any time in life. So they can present in adolescence, they can even present in adults. And because we normally don't think about metabolic errors as a diagnosis, it's important, particularly during the neonatal period, to have a very high index of suspicion. Kyunki ye general sa usool hai. A metabolic error, the severer it is, the earlier it will present and the more fulminant and fatal it's going to be. So have your index of suspicion high. Now these metabolic errors, they are basically single gene defects. So you know that all the metabolic processes that are taking place in the body are under the influence of enzymes or transporter proteins. And each of these enzymes, the synthesis of the enzyme is controlled by a gene. So if that gene is missing or defective, then you will have an enzyme which is missing or defective. Also, the degree of defect can vary. So ye black and white mein nahi hota, all or none phenomenon nahi hota. Some enzymes may be under the influence of more than one gene. Ya gene ki complete absence ki wajah deletion ho sakti hai. So you can have a spectrum of disorders in many cases, ranging from mild to severe. So while the severer ones will present early on in life, the milder ones can present at any time. So there are a number of ways in which these metabolic errors, jinki basic pathophysiology, can damage the body. So you can have a block in a metabolic process, or ho sakta is block ke beyond jo cheez banni ho, jo chemical banna ho, that has an important role to play in the body. So obviously blocking that pathway will lead to depletion of that essential chemical that will have deleterious effects on the body. At the same time, because the metabolic pathway is blocked, you can have increasing amounts of substrates before the block. So that can cause a toxic accumulation and that can have a negative effect on the body. Then usually the metabolic processes are not single process, unke ek se zyada limbs hote hain. So you can have intermediates from an alternative metabolic pathway that are increase in amount. Then you can have defects in energy production, jo cheez aapki short ho rahi hai, maybe that is ATP or ATP linked energy substrate. So that can have widespread effect. It can involve all organ systems of the body and would eventually be incompatible with life. And you can have a combination of these pathophysiological processes that take place. So I'll just try to explain it through these figures. So look at this figure. So there's a precursor substance A, precursor protein ho sakti hai, glycoprotein ho sakti hai. Let's suppose under normal circumstances, there's an enzyme here that converts it into D and then a final enzyme that converts it into E. Let's suppose is a final product. This might be ATP, this might be an important enzyme in the body, this might be an important protein in the body. Now let's suppose that this metabolic pathway is blocked because of enzyme absence. So A cannot be converted, A will be converted to D, but D cannot be converted to E. एट द सेम टाइम बिकॉज आई सेड कि बहुत सी साइड लिम्स भी मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेसेस के होते हैं एट द सेम टाइम इन अ बैलेंस पार्ट ऑफ ए गेट्स कन्वर्टेड टू बी एंड देन इवेंचुअली टू सी सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इफेक्ट ब्लॉकिंग दिस सिंगल एरो और दिस सिंगल मेटाबॉलिक पाथवे कैन हैव सो व्हाट यू हैव इज ऑब्वियसली सबस्ट्रेट जो ई से पहले आ रहा था डी D will just tend to accumulate because there's no enzyme now to convert D into E. And at the same time, A ki jo alternative pathways hain, which involve formation of B and then C will also be accelerated. So you can have more than normal amounts of both B and C. So a combination of these factors, absence of E, increasing amounts of D, which may be toxic, increasing amounts of B or C, which will definitely be abnormal, and maybe E was involved in synthesis of ATP, energy failure. So you can have these factors acting in combination that will produce then eventually the signs and symptoms of that particular enzyme deficiency or that particular metabolic error. So I hope this is clear. Now, as I said, because there are several varieties of metabolic errors, and what I've tried to do is lump them all in this one lecture, which is very difficult. Yaad rakhein, widely varied in presentation honge, depending on which metabolic process is blocked. You know, our body is the storehouse of different metabolic processes. Therefore, inki presentation will vary greatly. So, age of onset, general lekin rule, the severer a disorder, the earlier it will present, the more fulminant the course, the more poor the outlook. And obviously, then the mode of inheritance will also vary, and that will have an impact on the presentation. So you can have disorders which are autosomal recessive that will present in some siblings, not in others. They're commonly seen in areas where there are a lot of intermarriages, first cousin marriages. So jo aapke recessive traits hain, when they combine in the offspring, they can produce a disorder which was hitherto not present in both the parents, and these disorders will follow a typical inheritance pattern. So in each pregnancy, there'll be a 25% chance of the next offspring being affected. Then you can have certain disorders like Nish-Nayan syndrome that will be X-linked. And X-linked disorders, you know, the females in the family will be carriers and males will be affected. It's a typical pattern hoga, whereby maternal uncles will be transmitting the disorder. All who will have history of maternal uncles being affected and then nephews being affected, whereas the females will just be carriers. So this is just a list of different metabolic errors, and you can have disorders of protein metabolism, which include aminoacidopathies, organic acidemias, urea cycle defect, in which a particular amino acid, which may be a very essential amino acid, will not be metabolized appropriately. Toxic amount of these amino acids will accumulate, cause acidosis in the body, cause various problems in the body. So you see, even an essential amino acid, which in a normal person is absolutely essential, jiske bagair aapka metabolism nahi chal sakta, agar uske metabolize karne ka, usko utilize karne ka enzyme deficient hai, that essential amino acid can become a toxin for the body. You can have disorders in carbohydrate metabolism, jinme se kuch hum greater detail mein study karenge. So we'll talk about glycogen storage disorder, we'll talk about galactosemia in greater detail in subsequent lectures. You can have lysosomal storage disorders, likewise fatty acid oxidation defects, children who suffer from fatty acid oxidation defects have a sudden energy depletion, they can present with sudden death. You can have mitochondrial disorders, again widespread manifestations, because all the organs of the body that are dependent on mitochondria and energy generation because of mitochondria will suffer. Likewise, you can have peroxisomal disorders. So, inka jo hai incidence is widely varied, but collectively they can, as I said, present pretty frequently. So, you can have disorders that vary in frequency from 1 in 1400 newborn babies to 1 in 5000 live births. Then there are multiple forms that can differ in mode of inheritance that we've talked about. And obviously, jo iski gender bias hai, that depend on what the mode of inheritance is. Jo maine aapko pehle hi bata diya ki X-linked disorders will predominantly affect male babies. Age of presentation, again, the severer the disorder, the earlier the onset, and the more fulminant the course, you can have milder varieties in which the enzyme may not be totally deficient, it may be dysfunctional or lesser in amount. And these people will, patients will then kind of exist, they can jump into stress cycle, like an intercurrent infection or a particular diet, they will then plummet and present to you acutely. Now, disorders of metabolism of essential nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, and fats, they will generally have a tendency to present very early on, like within the first week. इसमें होता ये कि आपको carbohydrate या protein या fat जो baby diet में ले रहा होता है वो metabolize नहीं होती, and it accumulates in toxic amounts and becomes a poison for the baby. Usually even the very severe one will take about a week to present. क्योंकि जब हम remember जब हम neonatology कर रहे थे मैंने आपको बताया था, it takes a week for a baby, about a week for a baby to go on to full feeds. So ek martaba jab wo full feeds pe chala jata hai, then this baby can present acutely and severely. Now generally jaisa maine aapko bataya, the carbohydrate, protein and fat disorders will present in the neonatal period. Fatty acid oxidation defect, lysosomal storage disorders, these storage disorders hain, they present insidiously. For example, म्यूकोपॉलीसैकेराइडोसिस, जिसमें कनेक्टिव टिश्यू की ब्रेकडाउन अप्रोप्रिएट और रीबिल्डिंग नहीं हो रही होती, एंड दिस कनेक्टिव टिश्यू व्हिच इज अनमेटाबलाइज्ड विल देन गेट स्टोर्ड इनटू आइदर द लिवर, स्पीन, बोन्स, जॉइंट्स, वी स्टडी अबाउट दिस लेटर ऑन, और अपीयरेंस बच्चों की चेंज होती है, एंड यू नो अगर ब्रेन में एक्युमुलेट हो रहा है तो देयर माइलस्टोन्स विल गेट अफेक्टेड, जॉइंट्स में एक्युमुलेट हो रहा है, दे प्रेजेंट विद जॉइंट डिफॉर्मिटीज. तो इस तरह के डिसऑर्डर्स जिनमें ये एक्युमुलेशंस हो रही है, ऑब्वियसली ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम प्रेजेंट करेंगे, वंस द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस स्टोरेज बिकम्स विजिबल. देन देयर आर सर्टेन डिसऑर्डर्स जिनमें दैट इफेक्ट द न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर इन द ब्रेन, एंड दोज हैव अ लेटर प्रेजेंटेशन, दे प्रेजेंट अ सर्टेन न्यूरोलॉजिकल और साइकियाट्रिक इफेक्ट्स इन एडोलेसेंस एंड इवन एडल्टहुड. सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट द एज ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन. नाउ हिस्ट्री में क्या क्या पॉइंटर्स हैं that make you suspicious of a metabolic error. So bachon ki history mein developmental delay, regression of milestones achieved ki, neck holding achieved ki, sitting walking achieved ki, and after 1 year the mother comes to you and says ye chal raha tha ab chalna band ho gaya, ab baithna bhi band ho gaya. So that sort of regression. Onset of symptoms with change in diet, the children who have fructose intolerance, jo fruit sugar hai wo tolerate nahi karte. So when they are at an age when parents and mothers start giving them fruit in their diet, they find these children become sick. And mothers can usually form a correlation between sickness and intake of a particular dietary substance. Then you will have babies who are doing relatively well, they can have minor illness with upper respiratory tract infection, which is common. And then you have a sudden severe unexplained decompensation that makes you think there's something more to it than meets the eye. इस तरह की अगर हिस्ट्री मिले सस्पेक्ट अंडरलाइन मेटाबॉलिक डिसऑर्डर, देन हिस्ट्री ऑफ अनएक्सप्लेन्ड न्यूनेटल और सडन इन्फेंट डेथ, मैंने आपको बताया यू नो मेनी फैटी एसिड फैट मेटाबॉलिज्म डिसऑर्डर्स, एमकेर, सेवरल डिसऑर्डर्स ऑफ एनर्जी फेलियर कैन प्रेजेंट विद सडन इन्फेंट डेथ. यूजली आपको इसमें पेरेंटल कॉन्सैंग्विनिटी की हिस्ट्री मिलती है, पेरेंट्स आर फर्स्ट कजन्स, बिकॉज़ मेजॉरिटी ऑफ दीज डिसऑर्डर्स आर ऑटोसोमल रिसेसिव एंड दीज जीन्स टेंड टू पूल इन सर्टेन फैमिलीज, पॉपुलेशंस में पूल कर जाती हैं. सो इन एरियाज वेयर देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ इंटरब्रीडिंग यू कैन हैव एन इंक्रीज इंसिडेंस ऑफ दीज डिसऑर्डर्स. फिजिकल फाइंडिंग्स क्या होंगी? सो फिजिकल फाइंडिंग्स कैन वेरी फ्रॉम कम्प्लीटली नॉर्मल अपेयरेंस टू मेजर डिसमॉर्फिक फीचर्स. They can be non-specific, they can relate to major organs. You can have children with hepatosplenomegaly, children who present with failure to thrive because they're just not generating enough energy. Many times babies come to notice because they have some unexplained odor. So disorders such as what is called maple syrup urine disease, so called because the urine of these babies has a smell of maple syrup, which is a disorder in which certain essential amino acids like valine, leucine and isoleucine are not being metabolized, or in precursor products then accumulate in large amounts in the body and blood, and that get excreted in the urine and impart a peculiar odor to the urine. So for neonates, any newborn who comes to you who's critically ill, who who deteriorates after an initial period of apparent good health. And they say a term baby who's showing signs of symptoms without there being any risk factor for sepsis, consider metabolic errors. जब हम नियोनेटोलॉजी कर रहे थे मैंने आपको बताया था न्यूबॉर्न्स कैन प्रेजेंट ओनली इन अ वेरी लिमिटेड वे लाइक दे विल प्रेजेंट विद पुअर फीडिंग लेथार्जी लॉन्ग जॉन्डस सीजर्स यू नो इरिटेबिलिटी फ्लॉपीनेस हाइपोटोनिया तो कोई भी जो डिसऑर्डर हो उसमें जनरली प्रेजेंटेशन न्यूबॉर्न्स में एक जैसी होती है सो इफ यू हैव अ न्यूबॉर्न जो हफ्ता रिलेटिवली वेल रहा है और मदर आपके पास लेके आती है और कहती है कि आप इसे फीड पोअर कर रहे हैं आप उसको एग्जामिन करते हो डीपी जॉन्डस्ट है फिट्स की आपको हिस्ट्री मिल रही है फ्लॉपी लेथर्जिक यू थिंक इट्स सेप्सिस बट यू कांट फाइंड एनी अंडरलाइन रीजन फॉर सेप्सिस दिस इज अ टर्म बेबी हैज नॉट बीन इन द हॉस्पिटल यू नो आप उसका सेप्टिक स्क्रीन कराते हो वो नॉर्मल आता है सस्पेक्ट मेटाबॉलिक एरर पर्टिकुलरली अगर ये मदर आपको हिस्ट्री दे दैट शी एंड हर हस्बैंड आर फर्स्ट कजन्स या देयर इज हिस्ट्री ऑफ सडन अनएक्सप्लेन्ड इलनेस इन other newborns as well, there have been newborns who have died with undiagnosed, be very suspicious. So as I said, newborns can present with dehydration, temperature instability, breathing rate, either they'll be tachypneic, they'll go apneic, they'll be bradycardic with poor perfusion, irritable, abnormal tones, seizures, altered level of consciousness. So generally newborn ke, you know, sepsis ki presentation hai, wohi inborn errors of metabolism, maybe newborns is jitna present kar sakte hain. तो आपका डिफरेंशियल जो है वो सेप्सिस रेस्पिरेटरी इलनेस क्योंकि एसिडोसिस की वजह से दीज चिल्ड्रन में बीटा किपने दे मे हैव रेस्पिरेटरी डिस्ट्रेस दे मे प्रेजेंट विद कार्डियक कॉम्प्रोमाइज जीआई ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन रीनल डिजीज और सीएनएस प्रॉब्लम सो व्हेन यू एग्जामिन यू कैन हैव अ बेबी हु हैज डिसमॉर्फिक फीचर्स और मे लुक कंप्लीटली नॉर्मल स्केलेटल मैलफॉर्मेशंस मे बी प्रेजेंट ऑल्दो ये फीचर्स जनरली न्यूबॉर्न एज ग्रुप में नहीं आते ये जनरली लेट आते हैं you can have certain metabolic errors, certain type of glycogen storage disorders that present with intractable heart failure. I mean, they're so severe that towards the end of 1 month, ye bache bahut fulminant heart failure mein aayenge, which is very difficult to control. They can have hepatosplenomegaly, they can have generalized hypotonia. So this is a picture of Zellweger syndrome. This is a disorder of peri-oxidomal defect. A disorder of energy depletion and notice this child has dysmorphic features agar aapko exactly pata nahi bhi chal raha hai ki iska high forehead hai depressed nasal bridge hai and low set ears and these children sometimes come with prolonged neonatal jaundice you can tell just by looking at this baby that he doesn't look normal so this is what is known as being dysmorphic so as you move on 1 month to 5 years ke age group mein main aapko generally bata deti hu although they can present in a similar way to newborns but generally ye liver failure ke features ke sath aate hain so you can have children who present with vomiting ataxia seizures lethargy coma Reye syndrome like features hepatic encephalopathy they can present with poor feeding failure to gain weight or they may be developmentally delayed because you can have toxins that are accumulating in the brain you can have regression of milestones that I mentioned earlier and remember the more severe the symptom the more rapid the development of symptoms the longer the recovery time the more severe the illness you're dealing with so maine aapko bataya liver dysfunction ke sath bahut se bacche present karenge many of them towards you know the end of this 1 month to 5 year period will present with coarse facial features and failure to thrive we've already mentioned as you enter the adolescent years the disorders become more subtle they become more milder more difficult to recognize so is age group mein certain neurological or psychiatric abnormalities there are certain disorders in which the child may look and behave normally lekin as he or she approaches preteen years in many types of mucopolysaccharidosis school se aapko uski shikayatein aani shuru ho jati hain the teacher which says that he's very aggressive he's failing in school performance he fights with all the children he becomes physically violent that sort of subtle presentation can also be present then many of them will present with cardiomyopathies with hepatomegaly regression of milestones as mentioned or general developmental delay with neurological features such as ataxia hypotonia or visual and auditory disturbances Then these children, as I said, will present more subtly as autism, behavioral disturbances, we talked of aggressiveness. You will also have a history where the features may be intermittent. So you can have periods where a child is completely normal with periods when he displays signs and symptoms. This is a photograph of a child with mucopolysaccharidosis. MPS mein kya hota hai? MPS mein jo aapka connective tissue hai, uski metabolism disorder hoti. So normally our connective tissue is continuously being broken down and laid out afresh. So we retain a fine facial features, we retain mobility of joints. In bachon mein sara kuch nahi hota. This process of an orderly metabolism is absent, and they just tend to accumulate these connective tissues in their underneath their skin, in their hair, in their eyes, in their livers, in bones, in their brains, in spleen. So they have these peculiar coarse facial features. We'll talk about these disorders later on. अच्छा अब आपके पास एक बच्चा है of suspected inborn error of metabolism. अब आप क्या करेंगे? Now you can have lab work. Which is available in this country, but you can also have a complex test which may not be available. Lekin maine aapko batana hai, because obviously you need to know about these, you know, for academic reasons. Now remember, if you have a child, particularly a newborn, who presents with septic-like symptoms and has this triad of metabolic acidosis, hypoglycemia, and hyperammonemia, all of these investigations are available here. अगर उन सिम्टम्स के साथ और मुझे ये रिपोर्ट्स में मिले, then I become almost certain that we are dealing with some sort of metabolic disorder. So remember this triad: metabolic acidosis, hypoglycemia, and hyperammonemia. This is very, very suggestive in appropriate setting of clinical features of inborn error of metabolism. You can have other findings, like incomplete blood count. You can have thrombocytopenia that happens in many. Organic acidemia, you can have electrolyte abnormalities. मैंने आपसे जिक्र किया था, or maybe I forgot to mention. So, but you must all have read about it. ये जो आपके congenital adrenal hyperplasia होती हैं, these again are metabolic disorders in which enzyme processes are deficient, and you know, a certain limb of a particular interlinked metabolic process is absent. And you can have abnormalities of glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, and adrenal androgens. And these children can present, for instance, ho sakta hai unka glucocorticoid synthetic pathway absent ho, so they just end up going into alternative pathways, producing more of aldosterone, more of adrenal androgens. So they can present it because of high or low amount of mineralocorticoids. Electrolyte abnormalities. So, some children with congenital adrenal hyperplasia can have hyponatremia with very high potassium levels. Then abnormalities in bicarbonate, low bicarbonate, abnormalities in blood gases, metabolic acidosis. These sort of findings in appropriate setting should alert you to inborn error of metabolism. So you can have disturbed liver functions. You can have disturbed renal functions that we talked about earlier. Then again, ये investigation जो मैंने लिखी है, urinary amino acids and organic acids. Now, when I was training, these were not available, and we used to have a lot of difficulty. But now, our fund is doing these tests, so now we can diagnose things such as organic acidemias and amino acidopathies with relative ease. You can have excessive amounts of intermediate toxic metabolites in the patient's blood, which then get spilled over in urine. Or urine ki agar aap ye screening kare, so you can have an idea of the kind of metabolic error you're dealing with. Other investigations that may or may not be available here, and these include histological evaluation. So you can take histology and look at the morphology of the cells. For instance, in glycogen storage disorders, abnormal amounts of glycogen accumulate in the liver. So when you look at these hepatocytes, they have dactylations that are filled with abnormal glycogen, and they stain differently from ordinary normal hepatocytes. And you can have enzyme assays. So whatever enzyme is deficient, you can just look at the levels of these enzymes, or you can do a genetic analysis, which will give you your diagnosis extremely accurately and exactly pinpoint the diagnosis. But unfortunately, many enzyme assays and many genetic tests are not available in Pakistan. So other lab investigations that might be helpful include serum lactate. These are usually raised in many metabolic disorders because आपका जो pathway है energy production का, the normal pathway that has been bypassed, you can have anaerobic pathways that come into action which lead to increasing amount of lactate and pyruvate. Then you can have abnormal accumulation of triglycerides, uric acid, organic acid, amino acids, मैंने already mentioned किए हैं. Then odd acids in the urine, you can have findings, abnormal biochemical findings in the cerebrospinal fluid, things such as non-ketotic hyperglycinemia. These babies present with hiccups, or and hiccups can actually start as early as in utero. And mothers will tell you of abnormal movements. जब आप उनका CSF करते हो तो उसमें ग्लाइसिन के लेवल्स बहुत हाई होते हैं. So how do you manage these children? So आपके पास एक बच्चा आया जो hyperammonemic है, metabolically acidotic है, electrolyte abnormalities है. You don't know what the exact diagnosis is. Lab work आते आते time लगेगा. But you have to know how to manage them if you want to save them from dying. In the emergency, in the ER. So the initial steps aapke maintaining airway, breathing and circulation, never forget that. Particularly for newborns, consider antibiotics for two reasons. Number one, as I said, many of them will present with features of sepsis. So only later on that you'll know for sure whether they're septic or not. So antibiotic cover aap de sakte hain. And also many metabolic disorders would be controlled, but would then patients will plummet because of intercurrent illnesses. So consider antibiotics in these children. Many of them, and I've said, are hypoglycemic. Correct their hypoglycemia. Give them IV dextrose. Otherwise, they will continue to break their proteins and their fats in order to provide energy to the body, and the toxic substances will just tend to accumulate. Make sure that you look at your electrolytes and try to normalize them with appropriate adjustments. Treat acidosis, use bicarb where needed, fluid repleat them. Restrict intake of offending substrate. Many a times we have these newborns jinko hum NPO karte the and we start them on 10% dextrose to provide them with the needed calories. And just by virtue of the fact that unko diet aapne deni band kar di hai, you can actually reverse the clinical features of many of these inborn error of carbohydrate, protein, or fat metabolism. So just give them, dextrose, which is glucose broken down into its very simplest or basic units, and you reverse the clinical features. And this actually is a pretty strong indicator that you're dealing with a metabolic disorder. As soon as you stop their feed and you give them 10% dextrose, they improve. The minute you start feeding them again, they again go down. So this is a very, very strong indication that you're dealing with an underlying metabolic error. You can promote excretion of toxic metabolites by dialyzing them. Initially, aap unko peritoneal dialysis pe, and later on, you can start hemodialyzing them. Then specific treatments, if they're hyperammonemic, you can give them sodium phenylacetate or sodium benzoate. Then sometimes you blindly start arginine, L-carnitine, L-carnitine, pyridoxine, or biotin, because these are substrates that are involved in many metabolic disorders. So giving them large doses then reverses the toxic accumulation of many products or unki utilization ko enhance kar dete hai. So all these products are available here, and without actually knowing the exact metabolic problem that we're dealing with, we tend to give these metabolites or amino acids, and many a times the child gets better. Long-term management depends on your pinpoint diagnosis. They may need special diet. अगर कोई बच्चा है जिसको कोई particular amino acid, like मैंने आपको mention किया maple syrup urine disease, उसमें leucine, isoleucine, and valine may be the culprit, then you need special formulas जिनमें ये essential amino acids absent होती हैं. And then there are many babies who have urea cycle defects. So a protein for metabolism, such as urea, banta hai, they can't excrete those. So you need to give them formulas which contain proteins that are completely hydrolyzed. You might need substrate replacement. Jo maine pehle aapko mentioned ki thi, L-carnitine, biotin, pyridoxine. Many of them will respond to a bone marrow transplantation. एंजाइम रिप्लेसमेंट थेरेपी, बहुत से एंजाइम्स आर्टिफिशियली सिंथेसाइज हो रहे हैं. तो अगर एंजाइम डिफेक्ट पिन पॉइंट हो जाए, यू कैन गिव देम आर्टिफिशियल एंजाइम्स, एक्सोजेनस एंजाइम्स, बट दिस इज अ लाइफ लॉन्ग रिप्लेसमेंट थेरेपी. इन जीन थेरेपी ऑब्वियसली इज यू नो एक्सपेरिमेंटल. जेनेटिक काउंसलिंग, नेवर फॉरगेट. The parents want to know what defect it is, whether it can recur in the next pregnancy or not. So, to the best of the information that you can get, you can counsel these parents. Agar aapko exact genetic disorder pata chal jaye, you can look at the genome of the parents and tell them if they are carriers or not, or whether this disorder happened de novo. You can tell them whether it's an X-linked disorder, not autosomal recessive or dominant disorder. So lots of questions, parental questions, very important to put the parents' mind at ease. So I think last, this is our last slide. Yes, it is. I hope this has given you a flavor of what metabolic disorders are all about before we go on to study more specific disorders. Now, the thing is, I'm really sorry ki yahan pe cross question is waqt hum nahi kar sakte because you know I have to give this recorded lecture to you. आपकी क्लास के टाइम पे आई हैव समथिंग एल्स टू डू, बट इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज फील फ्री, बिकॉज वी आर इन आवर ऑफिसेस, प्लीज फील फ्री टू कम टू मी इन द पीडियाट्रिक्स डिपार्टमेंट इन माय ऑफिस फॉर एनी क्वेश्चंस, और यू कैन यू नो ईमेल इट टू मी फॉर दोज ऑफ यू हु हैव माय ईमेल एड्रेस और माय सेल नंबर. प्लीज प्लीज फील फ्री टू कॉन्टैक्ट मी व्हाटएवर यू वे यू कैन इफ यू हैव एनी अनआंसर्ड क्वेश्चंस. So I think until next time, until we meet next time, it's Khuda Hafiz from me, and take good care of yourself. Stop share and meeting kar do.